Welcome to PitStop 12. The following video is one in a series of clips designed to highlight the latest features available in PitStop version 12. PitStop Server 12 now uses the same underlying technology for flattening transparencies as Adobe Acrobat, InDesign, and Illustrator. In Acrobat, you can access the flattening feature from the Flattener Preview function in the Print Production Tools, or from the Actions in the Transparency tab in the PitStop Inspector. In PitStop Server, there is, like before, a separate tab to define the use of the flattener. Here are the settings of that tab in PitStop Server 11, and here are the new settings in PitStop Server 12. These settings should be familiar to anyone who is used to flattening PDF files in Adobe applications, as they are basically the same. More information is available about the flattener settings on the Adobe website, so we will focus here on the few differences. The flattening process creates new objects in order to keep the visual integrity of the file after flattening. These objects here have no ICC profile attached to them, but after flattening, the newly created objects are now tagged with an ICC profile. In Adobe Acrobat, the profile is that of the corresponding working space in the Preferences. In PitStop Server, it is that of the corresponding color space in the Color Management settings of the queue. When you use a transparency blending color space, the ICC profile attached to these objects will be that of the blending color space you selected. This is true for Adobe Acrobat as well as for PitStop Server. There is an option in PitStop Server to remove all ICC tags, something that is not available in Adobe Acrobat. We have this option for your convenience, as there is a good chance you will not want the ICC tagging behavior just described. The reason for this is that the flattener only tags new objects that it creates. The remaining objects are unchanged. This can lead to a situation where an object with a certain color, 100% cyan in this case, gets tagged, but a different object, also 100% cyan, does not. When this file is output, the RIP may interpret these objects differently, leading to a noticeable color difference. You could also solve this with an action list to remove the ICC tags, but it is more convenient to do this as part of the flattening process. The Adobe Acrobat Flattener has compression settings for flattener-generated images. The flattener in PitStop Server does not distinguish between flattener-generated images and non-flattened images. The Recompress Images option will therefore apply to all images in the file. It is important to note the order in which the different settings in PitStop Server are executed. Flattening, if activated of course, is done first. Next, the action lists. Then the pre-flight profile. So, if you want to perform actions like cleaning up black and converting RGB objects to CMYK before flattening, then you must set up two queues, where the output folder of the first queue is the input folder of the second. When you use PitStop Server integrated in Switch, this is, of course, very easy to do, as you can simply put two instances of PitStop Server in sequence, the first one performing the action lists, and the second executing the flattening and the preflight. Please be sure to watch all PitStop 12 related videos, which demonstrate even more features.